A single phase CSI current source inverter has a capacitor as the load. For a constant current, the voltage across the capacitor is. See, if capacitor is a load to a current source inverter. So what is a current source inverter? Current source inverter is basically a DC source in series with a large value of inductance. Okay, so this is a current source inverter. Now this fellow is feeding to a capacitor who is a load. Okay, and he wants, this is the current going through the capacitor, load current I can say. Okay, now for constant source current, so constant source current means this is the source current, isn't it? The load current itself is equal to the source current because all it is a series circuit. So source current to remain constant itself. Source current to remain constant means what? Like a DC, like this. Okay, he wants the source current or load current, both are the same, to remain constant. What should be the voltage waveform across the capacitor, he is asking. So in a capacitor, what is the capacitor current? IC is equal to CdV by dt. Now here the same capacitor current itself is the load current and this itself is the source current. So if this is the source current in this way, then what is the voltage? So voltage is nothing but, if I will want to find the voltage, then what I can do? I can do 1 by C integration of IS. That means integration of what? Integration of a step wave. This is a step wave, isn't it? This looks like a step function. So if you integrate step function, what do you get? You will get a ramp function. That is nothing but you are getting a ramp function. So if you want a constant current means, now this is the concept of inverters. In inverters, how does the constant current look like? The rectangular wave itself is a constant because you require a alternating current, isn't it? Alternating you require, and that alternation should be also of constant magnitude like this. Okay, so if your current is like this, then your voltage will be in this way, triangular waveform. Okay, so for a current source inverter, okay, for current source inverter, as you know, current is constant. So output current is constant means output current is constant like this. If output current is constant, then the voltage will be of the waveform triangular. Okay, this is very very important question, very very important, definitely this will be asked, okay, for many PSU examinations. Now you see, this question was asked number of times in many PSU and IAS 2014 also. A single phase full bridge VSI has inductor as the load for constant, okay, the current, please correct it, the current across the current through the inductor, okay, a small printing mistake, through the inductor is. Now you see, through an inductor, what is the voltage expression? Ldi by dt. Suppose you want to find what is the current through the inductor, then that should be equal to 1 by L into integration of voltage. Now for a voltage source inverter, voltage is constant. Okay, so constant voltage in an inverter means what? Square waveform, isn't it? A rectangular waveform. If a rectangular waveform is integrated, what do you get? You will get a triangular wave, isn't it? So the current is a triangular wave. Okay, so please remember, voltage source inverter, for voltage source inverter, voltage is constant. Voltage is constant means voltage is rectangular, and current is variable. For variable means what? A triangular wave will be there. Okay, similarly for a current source inverter, current is constant, isn't it? Current constant means current is a rectangular wave, and voltage is a variable quantity in a current source inverter. That means voltage will be having a triangular wave. Okay, very very important relation. So based on this conclusion, this question you can solve very very easily. This was GATE 2008 question, asked for 2 marks. But if any PSU wants to twist you or trouble you, waste your time, then they will ask you this kind of question. So now you see, based on that concept, how simply you can solve such kind of questions. A single phase source inverter is feeding a purely inductive load as shown in the figure, and the inverter is operated at 50 hertz in 180 degree square wave mode. So one thing you have to remember, so as I was telling you, the inverters are classified as single phase and three phase. Single phase will have half bridge and full bridge, and three phase again you will study under 120 degrees conduction mode, 180 degree conduction mode. So when you talk about how much will be the conduction in single phase, so for single phase, be it half bridge or full bridge, the conduction is always 180 degrees. Okay, for a single phase the conduction angle is always 180 degrees, but three phase you will have different mode, 120 and 180 degree mode. Okay, So that is the reason why 180 degree square wave mode. Assume that the load current does not have any DC component. The peak value of the inductor current will be. So he is asking you to find out what is the I naught max. Simply, I naught is the current through the inductor because load itself is an inductor, and he is asking you to find out what is the I naught max. So if you just, if I will draw the waveform of voltages and current in a this inverter. So as you know, inverter, this is a voltage source inverter. Okay, unless specifically mentioned, this is a voltage source inverter. Voltage source inverter means what? Voltage waveform will remain constant. So constant voltage waveform, let me draw waveform, that is how it looks like. Now he says that it is a single phase inverter. Now you tell me which is the, what configuration of inverter this is. This is a full bridge inverter, isn't it? So for full bridge inverter, the output voltage RMS will be equal to the source voltage, isn't it? So for a square wave, RMS voltage is equal to Vmax, isn't it? Vmax or RMS, V output RMS, both are the same. So from this I can write on what is the maximum voltage of this one. What is the maximum voltage? 200 volts. Again, negative peak will be equal to minus 200 volts. Now the voltage is constant from this time period, from 0 to t by 2 seconds, isn't it? Up to t by 2, the voltage is constant equal to Vs. Okay, and the voltage is appearing across which device? Across inductor. So across the inductor, voltage can be written as LdI by dt. Okay, so I know what is the voltage which is constant across the inductor, inductance value I know. I want to find out what is di by dt and how current is changing. Now, how current will behave with respect to an inductor? An inductor, voltage and currents are basically displaced by 90 degrees, and I lags voltage by 90 degrees. So I lags voltage by 90 degrees means, where is 90 degrees? Somewhere here will be the 90 degrees, and this is the 90 degrees, or 90 degrees, or I can also say T by 4, it will lag at T by 4, isn't it? Okay, so T by 4, so the current is lagging by 90 degrees means, the current waveform looks something like this the current waveform will be there, okay, where this is the minus I max, and this is what the plus I max means, plus I max. Okay, so during this time, okay, 0 to t by 2, when the voltage is remaining constant, how current is changing? Current is changing from minus I max to plus I max. So what is the net change? 2 I max is the net change. So you are supposed to find out the I max only in this question. And what is the time taken for this change? T by 2 minus 0 seconds, that means t by 2 second. If I want to write it in terms of frequency, that will be equal to 1 by 2f, that is the d by dt that has been taken place. So when I want to write the output voltage in terms of this one, then the L di can be written as 2i max into time is 1 by 2f, that will be equal to 2f. So from this, if I want to find out what is the maximum value of current, the maximum value of current will be equal to V naught by L into 4f, isn't it? L into 4f. So what is V naught? 200 volts. L is 0.1 into 4 times of 50. So 4 times of 50, 200 get cancelled out. 1 by 0.1 is 10 amperes. So option B is the answer for this question. You see how simple is this. But basically, if you want to do this kind of question, you have to remember a 4-year series output, and based on that, you have to do. So you need not, you know, mug up all the formulas at all the times. So many times these kind of basic understandings only will help you out in power electronics in specific. Now you see this question. This is also one interesting question. So in this interesting question, what is asking you is, you see here, it says that voltage source inverter is shown in the figure, it seems, to provide 50 Hertz supply. F is equal to 50 Hertz. The square wave AC output is across an RL load. Reference polarity V naught and direction of output current are indicated like this. Okay. Now you see, let us consider this is the load. Now you see, this is the total load. This is positive of the node, and this is connected to the negative, isn't it? Negative polarity, and this is connected to the positive polarity. Understood? So this is the positive and negative of the load. So current reference direction is, it is flowing from positive to negative of the load. That means current is positive. Okay. Current is greater than zero if this is the case. Okay, and reference voltage polarity is also given, plus minus V naught. Okay, now he has given the value of R and L millihenry. So in which interval, okay, when V naught is less than 0, I naught is greater than 0, that means when V naught is negative, that means minus plus, And when I naught is positive, which switches will be conducting, he is asking you. Okay, which switches will be conducting, he is asking you. So you have to find out when which switches are operating, you will get this kind of condition, that is voltage is negative and current is positive. Okay, so how do we do that? So how do we do that means, just I will do a trial and error. Okay, so what is the trial and error I will try to do is, now he says that V naught is negative. V naught is negative means, okay, this one which is supposed to be positive it has become negative, and this which is supposed to be negative has become positive. Okay, so when this is happening, which diodes or which transistors get forward bias, you tell me. Okay, so when this happens here, this diode gets forward bias, D3 gets forward bias, that means this will get short circuited. Okay, this gets short circuited, and again which gets short circuited, this diode gets short circuited, isn't it? This diode gets short circuited. So these both diodes get short circuited. So if I will draw the equivalent diagram for this one, that will be equal to plus minus okay, D3 is short circuited, this is D3, and this is open circuited. Again, D3 is connected to what? Negative of the load, isn't it? D3 is connected to the negative terminal of the load. Okay, this is the negative terminal of the load. So there is an RL load like this, and positive terminal of the load is connected to this point over here. So the positive terminal of the load will come and it will connect over here, and here D4 is again short circuited. Like this, D4 is short circuited, and this entire thing is again connected back to the negative terminal, isn't it? This is how the circuit looks like. Now this is the D4. Okay, this is the positive terminal and negative terminal. Now tell me what will be the direction of currents. Direction of currents will be like now. So he has given you the reference direction of current. Current is telling that is moving in this direction, the positive direction. If current is moving in this positive direction, now you see these diodes are in forward bias. So if diode is forward bias, what will be the actual direction of current? Like this only, no? So this should be the direction of current in the diode. If this is the direction of current in the diode, now you see the same current direction is been followed here in the load also. In the load current also, current is flowing from positive to negative. So when D3 and D4 is operating, I naught is positive because it is same as the reference voltage. Now what about the voltage? Now as I already told you, when the voltage is there negative, then D3 and D4 are short circuited. So automatically answer will be D3 and D4. Option D is the answer. Just by observation you can do it. Now you see this interesting question over here. IS 2003, it was asked, single phase half bridge inverter is fed from 48 volt DC and connected to a load resistance of 24 ohms. RMS value of fundamental component of the output voltage. See, again this is regarding half bridge inverter. I am writing out again all the formulas. Please pay attention. Please try to remember. These are very, very important. So for a half bridge inverter, output RMS voltage, okay, output RMS voltage will be equal to Vs by 2, okay, Vs by 2, and what will be the output voltage? Output voltage in general output voltage, average output voltage will be equal to V 2 Vs by n pi sin n omega t. Okay, if you want to find out what is the RMS voltage of fundamental component, fundamental component RMS voltage will be equal to root 2 Vs by pi. Root 2 Vs by I, where VOR is the total RMS component and this is the only fundamental component of the RMS voltage, divided by, again next if I want to find out what is the average RMS voltage or average voltage, RMS voltage, I want to find RMS voltage due to any nth harmonic, that will be equal to 2 into Vs by n pi simply. Okay, so from this I want to define another definition called as distortion factor, DF, distortion factor. Distortion factor in many textbooks is also called as G. So distortion factor says how much fundamental component of RMS voltage is there compared to total RMS component of voltage. So how much is there fundamental component of voltage is 2 into root, okay, 2 into or root, I mean RMS component of voltage is root 2 into Vs, isn't it, by pi, divided by total RMS component is Vs by 2. So that will be equal to G is equal to 2 root 2 by pi. Okay, 2 root 2 by pi. So this is the distortion factor for half bridge inverter. Okay, single phase. And also this is same for the full bridge inverter also. So when you do write down the equations of full bridge inverter and do this, you will get the same value. If this is G, distortion factor, there is another thing that we have to define, that is called as THD, total harmonic distortion, total harmonic distortion. Okay, so total harmonic distortion will be equal to generally 1 by G square minus 1. Okay, this is called a THD. So when you put that value and if you do it, then distortion factor or total harmonic THD will be equal to 48.34. that means very very high value, very very high, the distortion is too high, too high. Okay, therefore what we have to do is we have to use pulse width modulation techniques to reduce the THD. Okay, if THD is equal to 0, let us say if THD is equal to 0, when will THD will be equal to 0? When THD will be equal to 0 means what? Derating factor will be equal to distortion factor G is equal to 1. If G is equal to 1 means what? Total RMS component of voltage will be equal to the fundamental component of RMS. That means there is no harmonics, only fundamental component is there. Understood? So when you can eliminate the harmonics, then you can improve the distortion factor, this THD. As per IEEE, distortion should be less than 5% only in any system. THD should be less than 5% only. Okay? So these are some concepts associated with this thing. So when trying to solve this question, is asking you to find out what is the RMS value of fundamental component of the output voltage. So RMS value of the fundamental component of the output voltage is, this is only the formula. So root 2 into what is VS? VS is 48 volts divided by pi. So 2 into 48 by pi. So where is the answer? Answer root 2 into 48 by pi. Option C is the answer for this question. Okay. So if ever you don't remember this formula, if you ever you don't remember the formula, just remember, you have to remember this thing, that distortion factor will be equal to 2 root 2 by pi always for a full bridge and half bridge single phase inverter. And what is this distortion factor equal to? It is nothing but the RMS value of the fundamental component of voltage divided by total RMS component. So upon doing this, it is asking you to find out what is the RMS value of the fundamental component of the output voltage. That will be equal to the total RMS voltage, that is VOR into 2 root 2 by pi. What is the total RMS voltage of the single phase half bridge inverter? That is supply voltage by 2, that is 48 by 2 into 2 root 2 by pi, isn't it? 2 root 2 by pi. So 2 2 get cancelled, then here also you have 48 into root 2 by pi, 48 into root 2 by pi. This is the correct answer. Okay, so you see this answer, you got this like this. Now if I multiply and divide by root 2 and root 2, then what I will get? Then I will get 2 into 48 by root 2 into pi. Okay, root 2 into pi. So this is also correct answer now. So see here, option B is also correct answer over here. So for this question, these both are the correct options. Now the another question you see here, for a single phase half bridge inverter, amplitude of the output voltage is Vs, then the output power will be equal to, see, half bridge inverter means what is the output RMS voltage? Output RMS voltage is Vs by 2. That means output RMS voltage will be half the supply voltage. That means if the amplitude is this much, or he is telling that it is like this. Now what will be for the single phase full bridge inverter? So for a single phase full bridge inverter, output RMS will be double the half bridge. So for half bridge he is telling it is Vs, means for this one it will be 2 Vs, isn't it? So voltage for a full bridge inverter will be 2 Vs. Now you have to see what is the power. See, power delivered by the inverter is given by V by V naught by V naught square by R. So if voltage has now become 2 Vs square whole square by R, then power will be equal to 4 Vs square by the times, this is equal to the single phase power output. So power will increase by 4 times. So option D is the answer for this question. For a single phase full bridge inverter, so same type of question now you see, asked in the IES 2015. Now earlier he asked for half bridge, now he is asking for the full bridge, that is the only difference. So another time in IES 2015 recently, they have asked the same question. So IES 2015 and IES 2008, okay, this is 2008. In 2008 and 2015 also, they have asked the same question without changing. Just here he has given this, in decimal form, here is given in the option form, a fraction form, the options, that is the only difference. Both questions are the same. Now he is asking you to find out what is the fundamental component of output voltage for a full bridge inverter. Now I already told you distortion factor, be it a half bridge or full bridge inverter, this is equal to how much? 2 root 2 by pi only. So if that is equal to 2 root 2 by pi, distortion factor is equal to fundamental component of output RMS voltage divided by the total RMS voltage. Now you are supposed to find V naught R1, that is equal to 2 root 2 by pi into total RMS voltage of the output. So total RMS voltage of the output for a full bridge inverter is equal to the source voltage only. So 2 into root 2 by pi into what is the source voltage? 48. So what will be the answer for this question? So 2 into 48. So 2 into 48. So some option printing has been gone wrong. So it should be some 4 into 48. I'm sorry. 2 into root 2 into 48 by pi. So this is the answer for this question. It is simply double. Okay, if you are multiplying and divide by root 2, root 2 by root 2, then that should be equal to 2 into 48 divided by 2 by pi into root 2 simply. So I can write 4 into 48 by pi root 2. Okay, so the either way the answer is correct. Okay, both are the answer. So options are wrong. So if I am supposed to solve this, okay, in terms of decimal, then that would be equal to, you want 4 times 48 divided by pi times root 2. So I'm doing in my calculator, then I will get answer is equal to 43.2 volts. Okay, option D, 43.2 volts is the right answer for this question.